can't fix that, my boy.
That's fine.
But they can hear you fine.
Oh, you gonna have me in the recording? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I see you.
A Dan and Bali video.
Dan and Void Gear. I'll hear it.
Dan and Void Gear.
Chilling in the hot tub, 5 feet apart because they're not getting.
Alright, it's starting. Bali, are you watching? I'm trying to get out of this.
Just look for Nintendo Switch in the world where it started.
Dan and Void Gear. Indie world.
Indie stuff, I got you. Our terms of service have changed as of December 10th, 2019. Oh, wait, our terms of service will be updated on December 10th, 2019. So, Nintendo Switch Indie. Indie games is being Indie Game World Showcase.
Hi,
Indie World
Thanks
Showcase
for joining us. I'm Kirk Scott, your friendly neighborhood indie.
I should probably sign into my account.
Welcome
to the sign me in. Because I have it. This is now my laptop. Might as well use it as I see fit for a while.
Everything looks good so far.
Not to mention dungeons, espionage,
games, like this.
And enemies. Lead on your way to the Sports Story launches exclusively on Nintendo Switch in mid-2020.
In association with Sega. Wait, I'm trying to remember what game this is.
Goddamn.
On the tip of my tongue. There it is, Streets of Rage.
There will be plenty of brazen chicken lying around on crates and bad guys to beat down.
Sorry. I wasn't reacting to stuff. I was trying to sign into my account. Oh, Streets of Rage 4? Oh, in the first half of 2020? Say less. I'm hopping on that.
Say word
right now. Because I love Streets of Rage. I'm happy that it's finally getting a new game.
It's funny, I never played a Streets of Rage game. Until a few weeks ago.
Oh.
And I had to say I enjoyed it.
Wait, why is Streets of Rage being considered an indie game? Then I remembered it's technically speaking not made by Sega. So that explains why it's being considered an indie game as opposed to a full-blown official game.
Where's the UI, you ask? Where we're going, we don't need the UI.
Sega should really bring back some of their old IPs, to be honest.
Who needs them?
But we both know that Sega will never do that. Gleamlight looks pretty cool, not gonna lie.
Today we're gonna be showing you our brand new game, Bacon Switch. It's a violent, cute couch co-op game that I think you're gonna like. You like it. In fact, we like it so much, we made it about food because we like food. That's pretty good.
But the chocolate's kind of fat.
That's pretty gorgeous. Wow, that's the bliss ball right there. There you go. So we hope you guys like importantly, hope you enjoy it because we had to work really hard on it, baking this and making sure it works. So please enjoy it and let us know what you think.
See those patty things?
That's probably also the closest art program I'm not using it at the moment. Party brawler. You and up to three other can I close it? No, control Q. Entirely click your door then. Oh, what's this?
It's a food game.
Oh, I was about to say, it kind of looks like Animal Crossing.
Player versus player mode. It's every baker for themselves. Bake and Switch will cook up something special on Nintendo Switch in summer 2020.
Bake and Switch. On behalf of the team here at Digital Continuum. That title. That title, are you serious?
Supermish is a game that makes games. It's a love letter to gamers.
If the title of his game is Supermish, I'm gonna be very upset because how close it is to Super Smash. You know he had to do that on purpose.
They know what they were doing.
They knew exactly what they were doing.
Let's jump on the hype! Jump on the hype!
Basically, I'm gonna be like, yo, this character from Super Smash is gonna be in Smash Bros. UIX1W1. Oh, I get the idea now. Okay. That's a pretty cool concept, to be honest. Now, if this gets more updates and whatnot, make the games even more in-depth, I mean, you just might have to sit up there and, I feel like the modding community might get their hands on this, to be honest. Or they might put this on, like, maybe, say, Steam. Because I could see that happening.
Super Smash will shake things up on Nintendo Switch in May 2020.
May 2020? Might have to cop that. And I get a Switch. Oh man, I've seen people speedrun this game.
Tasked by your creator with solving a series of complex puzzles, you'll divert drones, manipulate laser beams, and even replicate time to prove your worth, or find a way out.
This is basically, I like puzzles, the game.
As you choose your own path through this non-linear world, uncover the clues you need to decide for yourself.
Void, this is Tetris.
Puzzles to solve. In the Talos Principle Deluxe,
hey, Tetris is my jam, my bread and butter.
Tetris.
Nothing quite like high seas adventure combining classic battle action and exploration.
This is Wind Waker.
This is Wind Waker. Deluxe.
Was that a panda there?
Huh?
I think it was a panda on the ship.
I wasn't even paying attention to the. To the thing.
That's why you smell like poopers, poop. And equipment.
As you progress, you'll add new boats to your ship and give orders to the crew on boats you aren't sailing yourself. Better keep track of the wind and use physics to your advantage. When Sail Forth sails into port on the 2020.
Hello, everyone. I'm Nick Clifford, developer here at Phoenix. Dawn. Since you last saw us during Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3 earlier this year, we've been hard at developing our hit online action RPG Dauntless for the Nintendo Switch system. We're absolutely thrilled to share a fresh look at our game, including the reveal of our new content expansion, Storm Chaser, complete with the Sky Fighter armor.
What is this?
I know, right?
This kind of looking. The model's looking kind of clean.
We hope you enjoy your
simplistic, but unique.
And we'll see you in the Shattered Isles.
Dauntless? Okay.
Monster Hunter?
No. This basically is just Monster Hunter, isn't it?
I wouldn't be surprised. It's Monster Hunter X4.
Mom, why'd that look like Mercy? Mercy, but she wants to punch you. Intriguing, okay.
It's definitely fucking... It's not for that X-Monster, I'm telling you. It's Monster Hunter. Did you not see she cut off the monster's tail?
Yeah, it's basically just indie Monster Hunter, which isn't bad, honestly.
It isn't. Ooh.
In Dauntless, you're all that stands between your world and the massive boss-sized machines that seek to devour. With cross-platform and cross-region play,
ooh, it's cross-platform. Where they
and with cross-save
cross-platform games make me hard.
Nintendo Switch, no matter where you begin your adventure. So form a
hunt. No game needs to be cross-platform. Cross-tag battle. Rich.
Create deadly. You just want to play against more people who aren't really good at the game, or don't you?
No, because I'm above average. Probably my ass. If the game is cross-platform, it's more people playing.
I mean, it's called cross-tag battle. It would make sense if it was cross-platform.
Ah, you caught on.
Dauntless is being released later today. Yeah, we should pop that, bro. Murdered by numbers.
Guess your only option is to dig up clues while jamming out the tracks of Masakazu Sugimori.
This is what I think it is. Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney and I'm going to be very upset.
I'm not going to say anything.
It's Professor Layton.
Was that Etika?
Oh my god.
You saw him?
You saw him? Deception
and this is basically Professor Layton meets Phoenix Wright. With OCs and stuff. Murder by numbers. I'm amazed. And yes, I did. You're talking about the guy with the flat top and the purple
skin. Bro.
This mysterious bounty hunter.
Ooh.
Because that's his name. He doesn't take kindly to guns. But he was trying to take your moolah in exchange for the
bounty. Oddworld, Stranger's Wrath. I'm getting serious, like, early 2000 vibes from this game.
Problem is, there's a bounty on his head. In this action adventure game, you'll wield Stranger's unusual crossbow that fires off rounds of live ammo. Rodents to bugs, you'll earn bigger bounties for live captures.
Okay!
With upgraded FPS controls and gyroscopic aiming, the definitive version of this classic is fast approaching. Oddworld, Stranger's Wrath launches on Nintendo Switch in January
2020. Stranger's
Oh man, why is this so adorable? You take an ordinary skateboard, you put a bird on it.
Is this Tony Hawk?
Is this Tony Hawk?
Bird skater?
Bird skater?
Bird skater, yeah. I'm actually surprised this is actually, like, getting more traction than I expected.
Birdie Hawk.
It was pretty famous. Birdie Hawk.
Pro skater.
Tony Bird.
Tony Tweet. Bird skater.
Tony Tweet.
They didn't name it that and they just lost me.
I think it's because they could have probably gotten sued for it, but.
They jumped the turnstile. I'm invested.
Oh. Is this gonna be a. Ooh, is this gonna be like one of those Telltale games, except your consequences and choices actually make a difference?
You saw it for yourself in the trailer, people. Liberated blends the art of cyberpunk, hand-drawn graphic novels with interactivity and action to create one seamless experience.
In this near-future dystopia, the eerily familiar, always-online society gives way to complete government control. But that won't stop an rising up.
Is that your phone?
Yeah. Billy. Billy needs to shut up right now.
He's already just like, okay. Alright, buddy. You need to calm down.
First, as a timed exclusive on Nintendo Switch in 2020.
Hi, we're Kid Hawk. This is our game for
Liberated
Dungeon Crawler Mashup.
You gonna drop a playthrough through that, Dan? Huh? You gonna drop a playthrough of that, my nigga?
Which means you'll be able to date your weapons at and on the go.
If you're like me, then you're never going to forget your summer stay.
And just a picture in the background alone.
Ooh! I love you know. This reminds me of Gaia.
This reminds me of what's the name of that one game where you play like this kid with like a hammer. Got the name.
Are you literally fighting a martini?
And there's also
something about that reminds me about Mother.
Level up your love.
Boyfriend Dungeon.
I'm trying to remember the name of that one game where like you play as like this kid, like this white-haired kid, and like you have to go around as the world is falling apart in a dungeon crawler fashion, and you got like this big hammer and other types of weapons. Okay, now this right here, and low-key looking pretty crispy.
Crispier than Popeye's chicken sandwich? I don't think anything can be crispier than a Popeye's chicken sandwich.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't think it'd be crispier than that, and I haven't even had one yet. Alright, and whoever's watching, just don't kill me. I just haven't had one.
You'll have one soon. Shirt,
yeah, someday.
Only my Popeye's has the goods. They're never running out.
I mean, you don't know about that yet, buddy, because there's one right near me, and I just don't go outside. Ever. Sorry for the aggressive typing. That's literally just how I did. I'm really aggressive with my keyboard. I'm surprised I shouted at one point, to be honest. Oh, what's this?
It's Minecraft.
It's Minecraft, but overhead view.
Overhead Minecraft. Pixelated.
Overhead Minecraft. It's basically Minecraft. That's why, yeah, this explains it. No wonder this looks so familiar. This is basically designed by the people who made Escapist, aka their sequel universe thing.
They change during the day-night cycle, and their rhythm.
Might have to cop this game.
As you or your mother,
you know, when I get a Switch.
Craft items. You'll uncover your own recipes and multiple crafts. That should help you find a hidden threat.
You can sit up there and be survivalist, me boy.
You can play co-op locally or online with up to 3 friends who each have their own team and system to try and survive together. However, not everyone is pleased to see you thrive. The Survivalists releases on Nintendo Switch in 2020.
We're coming. I'm watching the live stream chat for the Indie World Showcase, and everyone's just talking about how it's Minecraft too.
I told you it's Minecraft. I see it too.
Thank you so much, and thanks to all of you for joining us.
Is that it? This can't be it. Nah.
They act like they're showing Smash.
Yeah, thanks for watching, and I'm just like.
And they're like, there's just one more thing. But you're not Sakurai, don't do this.
Yeah, do not sit up here and get our hopes.
See, Shantae doesn't even count as Indy anymore. Because she would have been in here.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even think Shovel Knight counts as indie anymore. It's just too good.
I mean,
you can get kicked out of indie.
I was gonna say, what constitutes as really being indie, to be honest?
Just being your own developer making a game. You know, like using your own income.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. You are not in control, you are not yourself. You love the background of like what they're doing. It's killing my entire bitrate for this video.
Bro.
Like, the quality just tanked.
Huh. That wasn't actually bad. That was actually pretty good. For something so short. That was actually.
I'm getting Metro vibes from this game. Oh, Axiom Verge. No wonder. I've heard of Axiom Verge. Oh, that's pretty good.
Someone said Blue Lane. Disrespectful.
Yeah, they're here by them.
That they appreciate.
So, I guess it's our time to give our like personal opinions on favorites and what's not.
I mean, we can look back.
We have time. I mean, alright. I mean,
the ones that stick out to you most.
I would say the one that stuck out to me most by the time I actually got here. I would say probably Survivalist, because it takes what Escapist was, gives it more animations, and you know I'm an animation majorist.
Yeah.
AKA, I'm in college for animation, and I low-key love fluent animations, and let me just tell you.
The Survivalist?
Survivalist. Those animations actually look really good. I kind of like Liberate, because it kind of Liberated, because it kind of looks like a, it takes the whole like heavy, like dark and gritty comic aesthetic and puts it into a game, and you don't really see games do that as much anymore, because it was common before, but you know, it's kind of cool to see again. Let me go back and see which one. Let me see if I can find the one I also like. Because there was one, a Boyfriend Dungeon also looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
It reminds me.
Yeah. The really Boyfriend cool. Dungeon, the really was stuck out to me is just fighting cartoony enemies. And when I first saw it, before we saw the anime, it gave me Gaia vibes. Gaia Online vibes.
Yeah, I could see that.
But just fighting Martini gave me Mother vibes. You know how much of a Mother fan I am.
Yeah, I mean, you know how much I love Mother. Because Mother is one of those strange RPGs that inspired me in my life. But, I'm trying to think of the next game I actually really enjoyed.
What about Tony Hawk Pro Skater?
Tony Tweet, Brave Skate. Oh, yeah, I'll admit, I already knew about it prior. But, whoa, wait. Hold on, let me go back in the video. His name is Alex. Alex from Streets of Rage actually have an eye patch now? They made these characters look edgy. Well, besides Blaze. Oh, he's got sunglasses. Okay. He came in the Titan. He's buff. They really put Adam. Adam was his name. Oh my god, the animations for this are sick.
And then we have Monster Hunter. Dauntless.
Dauntless, I actually will admit, I kind of can dig. Yeah.
Is it free?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure you have to pay money.
Actually, I can check now. Let's see if they got Streets of Rage 4.
Oh, it drops in the first half of 2020. Streets of Rage 4. I need to talk about that. Okay. I don't know how many people are watching. I don't care, to be honest. I just want to get this on my channel.
It won't be that many. Probably not.
You could probably just upload this as a VOD anyway. But I just want to say this. Beat 'em ups, they're my bread and butter. I love beat 'em ups. And to see Streets of Rage, one of my all-time favorite beat 'em ups and a big inspiration for why I wanted to get into game design, actually get some love after so long of them failing to make it a 3D game. And the animations look as crisp as that for being an indie company. Yeah, they have my approval. I'm excited for it, and I like some of the new, like, what I'm assuming are, like, super specials, because I noticed that there's, like, the base specials, and then there were, like, the one that Adam did, where he, like, punched the ground and did, like, basically, like, a power geyser. I don't know what it's called in-game, but I'm gonna say power geyser. You do, like, the power geyser, and then the trailer ends. It looks really cool, and a lot of the character designs kind of show the progression of, like, I guess the time period of, from, I guess, the third game till the fourth game, because I'm pretty sure this is going to be a large time skip, but I'm absolutely excited for this game.
I wish I could be more, but what I've played from the game that I played, whichever trades I did play, that was actually really fun. And I actually like beating up games.
Streets of Rage.
Huh?
We're going to do a playthrough of Streets of Rage, let's go.
It looks really fun.
It looks really fun.
Once I saw Thick Legs, I was like, oh, yeah, definitely. Got thickums.
Super Mash actually looks very interesting. Like, I'm actually genuinely intrigued. I thought it was going to be like some like strange, like, Smash clone or something, but no. It's basically you take two genres of gaming and make them into one, which is honestly a really cool idea. Especially because it's like, wow, this is pretty cool. Like, you don't really see people do that. And I'm still watching the live stream chat for this stream.
You're being disrespectful.
Someone was like, this is a bad indie direct.
People out here roasting for no reason.
Yeah, what was your favorites and top opinions?
Well, for me, as of right now, I think, let me go back. I really want to, they need to release a demo of that, the bird skating game. I'd actually love to play that right now. For some reason, I haven't played like a Tony Hawk game in a while, and I think this is gonna actually be fun. Imagine if they had online capabilities for the game. That would be some wacky fun. Like four players online, one person that like have more airtime or tricks, that'd actually be good.
That'd be extremely wacky. Can I still get an animation program? Because I want to try and start doing animation again.
Trying to find out what. Dauntless definitely. It says later today, so I don't see anything on the eShop, so definitely later today. I'll check that out.
You're going to keep the eShop open?
No.
I would do that, to be honest.
But Dauntless actually looks really cool. Knowing how much I love Monster Hunter, I'm definitely probably gonna stop. Bacon Switch. That's what you were talking about, the bacon game? Oh no, you're talking about something else.
No, what I was talking about was Super Mash.
Yeah, you're talking about
Super Mash is the one I liked. Because it's from the sounds of it, it sounded like it was a Smash clone. But then when you actually looked at it in the gameplay, it showed that it was actually something entirely different, and I kind of liked the gimmick of what it was going for. With the whole, you combine two different classic genres, and it becomes one.
For Bacon Switch, it just looks like a fun game. And you team up with people. It reminds me of another cooking game. That's on the Switch right now, actually. You play as these mini people and you just make food. But since everything's like everywhere, I can't tell who are you making the food for or what are you doing. But there's power-ups apparently on what I'm looking at right now. And that looks like a giant oven. But it seems like it's four players locally. Probably online.
Yeah, I mean, well, the chance of an indie game being online is very minuscule, but you never know.
Gleamlight looks cool. It looks like, has a dark and gritty look to it. If you go back and look at see. Yeah, Gleam Light. That's what it's called. But the art style kind of looks like,
No, you also for which game?
It's called Gleam Light.
Oh.
It looks like Hollow Knight.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that one actually didn't really pique my interest.
It has, like, the same art style.
I'm entirely interested in it. Like, the art style is cute, but other than that, it doesn't seem that interesting.
As for everything, everything is pretty fine. But finding goddamn Etika in the video. Oh, I can't even look at it. I guess they re-uploaded. Because I can't look at the video now. Won't show me anything else.
Don't do time, I'll figure these things.
But that was actually really good.
Actually really good.
For 20 minutes.
It was.
For 20 minutes.
Yeah, Bro, it was essentially 20 minutes. There were some pretty good games. And I mean, I hope that this means that we're gonna get more indie-based stuff from Nintendo, hopefully. I'm not banking on it, but it is something I can hope for.
It seems like Nintendo's caring more about their indie titles coming. So that's what they're doing. But I mean, to show us this, because in 2 days, we'll have the Game Awards. So whatever they reveal, whatever they reveal. The simple fact that Reggie's gonna be back is gonna be great.
I mean, knowing Poppy Sakurai, he might sit up there and throw us curveball. Might not actually reveal anything.
He might not. They're gonna reveal the new Sonic game.
I'm like Sonic, and Sonic at the Sonic.